Delighted to be joined by Colin Ball. How are things, Colin?
Good, Dave, yeah, good fun.
Good weather again after getting over that storm now, thankfully. Your horses are flying, things are going well. You've had a good few 4-year-old winners already.
Yeah, they seem to be in right vein of form. They're good and they're healthy and yeah, nice to get off to a nice start.
You started off with Stargate, an Imperial Monarch horse down in Bell Harbour. He was very impressive, showed an unbelievable turn of foot. Here's the horses now coming up the gallop. He showed a very good turn of foot. Glenn Glass, first runner for Otawango. He was impressive as well, Colin. They were the first two winners that you had, 4-year-olds.
Yeah, David Stargate showed a lovely, lovely turn of foot. Rob kind of busy going to the last, but he seems to have a bit of toe. He's a good attitude and he's a smart looking horse.
And Glenn Glass, then he won in Tallow. Soft conditions, big horse, handled that well, and he was good.
Yeah, Dave, he won Tallow. He actually made a few mistakes. I think he got close to the third last. I think he missed the second last. Looked like he was going to get beaten. So, in fairness to him, he fought hard to win his race. And a very big, honest, genuine horse. But he has a good pedigree. He can't even name now. But his mammy won 5 races, and she bred a couple of black type horses. So, he's a good tough staying horse. And plus he's 17 too, so all he can do is improve.
On Saturday then in Cragmore, you had a mare that took on the geldings over 2.5 mile, and she was very impressive. Brandy Love, a Jetaway, which was two winners on the day for Jetaway.
Yeah,
won both 4-year-olds.
Yeah, he obviously must be a nice stallion. She was very impressive there. Ground was soft. She's probably about 16, maybe 16 and a half, hand tight. She went to the second last in the bridle, and Barry just said he's either going to the last, and she won easily. He actually said that she'd lowers left even going through the line. Yeah, she was very impressive.
And yesterday then in Punchestown and Nina, you had two more 4-year-old winners.
Yeah, yesterday I was in Nina. I ran two in the Auction Maiden. James Kenny rode one for me, looked like he was going to win, and Peter Kavanagh rode Velvet Elvis. He ended up the winner.
The Scirocco horse,
yeah. And we bought him in Doncaster. I think he was only maybe something like 12 grand, so he wasn't expensive. But he ended up...
He's a very impressive winner, wasn't
he? Yeah, he stayed on. It was fairly testing conditions, and I think he ended up winning maybe 15 lengths.
And then he had a getaway winner up in Punchestown, Rob James rode.
Yeah, Rob rode him. We liked him going there. He was after doing a couple of nice bits of work. A horse of one young fell at the last, but it looked like we were probably going the best of the two.
Yeah.
And he won easy.
And then you have another horse this week on the sale. All those horses, bar the horse that won in Punchestown, are going to the sales on Friday, bar the getaway horse.
The getaway horse pulled out a little bit stiff this morning. We'll probably leave him. It's not in serious. He's fine, but he'll probably miss the sales. Maybe we'll go to sales and chat in the festival.
So those other four horses will go on Friday, and you have Kilbeg King, then a horse who was an unfortunate second in Tinnehealy. Looked like the winner everywhere until just getting in tight to the last.
He got a bit tight to the last. Just didn't get it with his landing gear. He was beaten a half a length. He's a 5-year-old. He's a super attitude.
He's by Dion.
Dion horse. A couple of lads from Cork on him. Good attitude. Definitely win. He will win loads of races, and he's a nice horse.
The horses on a Monday, did you only go once there today, Colin? And you've got the sand recently topped up, and the gallop's a great asset to you.
Yeah, John Armour's on my work here. He got a new machine for putting on sand. It's a swivel. It does a 360. I don't know what it's called, but a mechanical, some wristed horse.
Yeah, we'll leave that to them.
Yeah, exactly. But no, he does all the work. We topped it up here about 3 weeks ago. It was very heavy. I was glad to see the rain coming, because it got very heavy. It was hard on how you're going, but it's after bedding in again now, and we're very happy with it.
Good day for Peter Kavanagh yesterday, having his second winner. So it's good opportunities for these lads when there's 3 meetings. They were able to spread the rides out, and of course Barry was suspended yesterday, so it gives even more opportunities.
Yeah,
then.
Yeah, I think that's what happened. Barry was gone missing for the day. listen, it's great when it's meetings, but. But you have to have enough horses, you see, to give the lads chances. We're fortunate enough here. We had enough horses. We had a horse in each meeting, so we're lucky enough to be able to give the young lads a chance. Yeah.
And the sale, as I said, on Friday in Cheltenham, and back to normal then on Saturday and Sunday. I'm sure there'll be plenty of runners the weekend then.
Yeah, but I think there's only one.
One 4 year old in Tinahili.
Yeah, and this time of year too, it'll struggle to divide. Probably won't divide. Yeah, we'll probably come back to ourselves Thursday night and get back into work on Friday morning and race again Saturday.
Listen, thanks very much, Colin, and best of luck on Friday with the sales.
Thanks, Dave. Thank you.